I'd like to thank you for taking part in one of demonstrations, countless in number, which have taken place across the world on this International Day of Action. What you have shown us, people I've never met before turning up for this demonstration, is that the 80% of the people in Venezuela, who, as many speakers have told you, are invisible, there are 80% of Canadians who are invisible too. And they are you. They're the people who say, not in our name. We are not responsible for what is happening. We have never voted on it. What Canada is now doing is a disgrace. It's taking part in something which, if they succeed, will lead to the murder of hundreds of thousands of poor black people. And nobody voted for it. They didn't even have the guts to put it to their parliament. So what can you do? It doesn't stop here. It begins here. This is where the resistance makes itself effective. Some very simple things you can do. If you haven't yet given us your email, give us your email. And we'll tell you about our lively meetings. Happens once, twice, sometimes three times a month, because things are very active, where you can take part democratically in deciding what we do, unlike Canada. Second, we can tell you when events like this are coming up. We've got some great meetings coming up. We're hoping that Nikki Ashton, bless her, is going to come and speak for the people of Venezuela. We're very pleased about that. We hope that Basha Sokal of Winnipeg Labour Council, which 2 days ago passed a motion against the coup and in support of Venezuela, we hope they will come and speak. We hope from representatives from the Latin American, other communities, faith communities, to show what Canadian people really feel. Watch out for that meeting and come to it. Last, we have two young people from this country, from this place, who are joining a delegation of 14 people who are going to Venezuela across Canada to see for themselves and come and report back. And that costs them. They're putting that money up themselves. We want to make sure that they don't have to. So we're going to be fundraising, and we hope you'll look out for that fundraising and contribute to get those young people to Venezuela, bring them back and hear what they've experienced about the reality of Venezuela. And the final thing you can do is this. The reason that the 80% of Canadians that I am convinced don't agree with what's being done are not heard is because they are told lies. They are told lies by their public broadcasting company, CBC. They are told lies by the Globe and Mail. They are told lies, unfortunately, even by the Winnipeg Free Press. They are told lies that are simply recycled statements from Washington State Department. So when Mike Pompeo, who we are told is the representative of everything evil in America by our own liberal government, tweets the lie that Venezuela has closed a bridge between Colombia and Venezuela, when in fact that bridge never opened. Tienditas Bridge was never opened. When they repeat the lie that it's Venezuela that's stopping the humanitarian aid from coming in, when United Nations says we are sending humanitarian aid and we don't place political conditions on it, that's a lie. That was simply repeated on CBC as if it was the truth. Mike Pompeo. When Elliot Abrahams is lauded as a champion of democracy, the guy is a war criminal, and is a convicted war criminal, and has been sent a special envoy to Venezuela. We are told that this guy has truth coming out of his honeyed lips. You can do something very simple. Write to the press. Every time you catch them in a lie, send them a letter. Write to the ombudsman. Every time you catch somebody telling a porky, say there's a pig there. And do it. It's a very simple, don't waste time with clicktivism. It's very targeted, very simple. Watch for the lies and pin them down. And how can you tell where the lies? You can visit the media sites that are starting to tell the truth. And we have a Facebook group. Find it, it's easy to find. Venezuela, Winnipeg, Venezuela Peace Committee. Google it. You'll still even find us. It's not yet been suppressed. Unlike the 2,000 Twitter accounts that have been suppressed by Twitter for telling the truth about Venezuela, you'll still find us. Join it, like it, you'll get information from that site. Find newcoldwar.org, Venezuela analysis, all sites with fantastic reportage, and inform yourselves. so that you can catch and refute the lies. Those are the four things we ask you to do. Thank you. This has been a wonderful event. Those of us who have been working for so long for the people of Venezuela are so happy, proud, and pleased to see you there. And we hope to see you again.
Who should have the final say? Voters or the CIA? Who should have the final say? Voters or the CIA? Who should have the final say? Voters or the CIA? Who should have the final say? Voters or the CIA? Hands off Venezuela! Hands off Venezuela!